Hey everyone, it's Tyler here, and just wanted to take a few minutes because we've got a new version of FiberCheck Pro version 2.0 that's about to roll out here in the early May timeframe. And so I'm going to be putting together a couple of internal training videos, just walking through some of those new features and how you can utilize those best and share them with your customers. But one of the first things that I wanted to talk about is usually whenever a new version of FiberCheck Pro rolls out, the engineers like to incorporate new versions of firmware for the different inspection microscopes as well. So I figured I'd quick walk through with you how to, say, update the firmware on your FiberCheck probe microscope. So I got my probe here, and the first thing I want to do is connect that into my laptop via a USB connection. The USB cable comes with the FiberCheck probe microscope. And once that happens, you'll see that the FiberCheck interface here changes to, there's a tab up at the top that says import, and that shows all the information that you have on your probe microscope. If I click on the inspection tab, that goes back to activating the normal inspection capabilities. But I'm right now looking at whatever's on that device, the FiberCheck microscope, and if it tells me what's available, what I've saved on there so far, what's new since the last time I imported, and of course here's where I'd import all those new things. But I want to take you to how to set up the microscope itself. You can see the device here is the FiberCheck probe with the serial number, and I'm going to go over into setup and choose the microscope itself. And now the user interface changes to this menu here with a couple of different options on the left. This first one is device information. It has things like the serial number and the latest firmware and such. Next one is device settings, like how long do you want it to stay on before it powers off, goes into sleep mode, things like that. The next one is the important one. Like I'd mentioned, whenever a new version of software rolls out, the engineers will roll out a new version of firmware as well. So you want to see what your current version is here and cross-reference that with whatever this latest version is here, and make sure that they match. If it's a new version, they won't. So you'll just click the button here, update firmware, and the process to update it takes about 1 or 2 minutes max, and then when it's done, it'll notify you, and it'll reset that for you. So 2 minutes and you're all up to speed. The next one is optical settings and analysis profiles. Now, this is how, let's say that you wanted to add a new optical setting for a certain kind of a tip or something, and you wanted to use that on your FiberCheck probe microscope. So here is whatever's on my device right now, and on the left is what's available that I've either shipped with FiberCheck Pro itself or things that I've created. So let's say that I want to take this special custom setting that I created for a U12A6, add that over to the device, and I'm all set. Next, I want to go into my analysis profiles and do the same thing. If there's anything over here that I wanted to add over to the device that is currently not on there, that's how I do it. Right now, there's actually nothing that I'd want to add, but for the sake of this here, I'm going to go and add this one here for an E2000 metal ferrule, for example. Let's say that I got a couple of those coming up. So now I've moved that over the device, and when I disconnect this, it'll be available in my menu options for the FiberCheck probe. Next is USB settings. This is I basically just recommend keeping this at auto. It'll auto detect how it connects with the device itself, the device and the software program. This is a new feature rolling out with FiberCheck version 2.0. All the different language supports. So in addition to English, now we've got all the different languages throughout Europe and Asia and Latin America on there. Next is licensing. Now, with the FiberCheck probe, it already comes by default supporting use with FiberCheck Mobile. But if you have a P5000i, that's an additional upgrade purchase. So if that wasn't available, this is where you'd enter your activation key. And then finally, user information. If you wanted to populate anything here about the job, customer, company, XYZ. And then now whatever you populate here will show up on your test reports. And that's about it. When you're done, you just click OK, and it'll take about a minute to resolve all that stuff and send that over to your FiberCheck probe microscope, and you're good to go. So with that, that's basically how you configure your probe microscope for latest firmware, for any custom optical settings or profiles so that you can use it on the device. Stay tuned for more videos. I'll be walking through some of the different features of FiberCheck Pro software and how you can make the most of the features that are available on the device. And with that, I'll talk to you soon. Have a good day.